spoke with Acting Governor, Attorney General, Jerry Brown, who signed the executive order, politics declaring this a national police state emergency, declaration of emergency. I invited him to the press conference this evening. He said he would rather have people that are here doing the information to the public, and he stands behind us 100%. If there's anything we do need, the state is there to give us that assistance. And I thank him for that on behalf of all the cities and the county of Los Angeles for his decisive action. And as you know, the governor's out of town. Jerry Brown is now the acting governor. To update you from this morning's press conference, today we've had 1,991 homes in advance of predicted storms that have been evacuated. In Acton, 51 homes. La Cunada, Flint Ridge, 251 homes. La Crescenta, 217 homes. Glendale, 348 homes. Tahunga Foothill, 803 homes. And Sierra Madre, 321 homes. This has been a team effort by our county departments and our local municipalities and law enforcement who have been on the front lines to protect life and property. LA County Fire, Sheriff's Department, the County's Fire Department, Public Works, the County of Los Angeles, the County Animal Control and Care, LA County Office of Emergency Management, the City of Glendale, the City of Glendale's Fire and Police, the City of La Cunada, the Bridge, and the City of Los Angeles Fire and Police, and the City of Sierra Madre have been involved. Our public safety network is working, and due to their professionalism, we have faced no major incidents. There have been no casualties and no loss of life. We also thank our town councils who have been technically involved in the preparations and preparing our communities for these storms. They shared vital information on their websites. That's the Cable Canyon Civic Association, Lucena Valley, Acton, Leona Valley, and Juniper Hills. As I said, we thank the acting governor, Jerry Brown, for declaring a state of emergency in the counties of Los Angeles, Orange, and Riverside. This will allow us to waive the necessary regulations which would hinder response and recovery efforts, but make recovery assistance available under the California Disasters Assistance Act, and it will expedite access to federal resources and disaster relief programs, including the United States Army Corps of Engineers. Our office is working closely with the Governor Arnold Schwarzenegger's office to meet the aggressive situation and to brief Jerry Brown on this as well. This coming Tuesday, we will ratify that declaration before the Board of Supervisors. There have been no arrests, there have been no deaths, and there have been no curfews in place. We want to thank the American Red Cross for their assistance in establishing the evacuation centers that we have. And they are located at the La Cunada Flintridge High School at 4463 Oak Grove Drive in La Cunada, at the Summit Park Recreation Center at 8651 Foothill Boulevard, at the Glendale Civic Auditorium at 1401 Park Boulevard, and Sierra Madre Community Resource Recreation Center at 611 East Sierra Madre Boulevard. The animal shelters, residents of Pasadena, La Cunada, Flintridge, La Crescenta animals are being accepted, and also all animals are being accepted at the Pasadena Humane Society, 361 South Freeman, Pasadena, and La Cunada High School, where at La Cunada High School they will be transported for those who are outside the area, Pasadena Humane Society. And the Department of Animal Control will also be offering free transportation, as I said. Now, for the residents of Acton, we are talking about the Estate Animal Shelter, the Lancaster Animal Shelter. If you have large livestock horses, we're talking about Pierce College and Animal Valley Fairgrounds. And for more information relative to the storm, you can visit the dpwcare.org Public Works website, or fire.lacounty.gov, LA County Fire Department, and lasd.org, the LA County Sheriff's Department, or the county's hotline, which is 211, which is County Information Line. So we have the good news is that there's been no loss of life, and while we wanted people to be who are evacuating to go back to their homes because of the unstable condition of the storm that's still continuing in this area and our Southern California, I will have to delay that information until tomorrow morning to give you a more update as to what can be done. For right now, encouraging people to be evacuated. They've been recommended to leave their home, and you have shelter available for you, it's more important that you save your life and your property for your assistance instead of having you be in the way, creating a serious problem for law enforcement, public